Congratulations.
Congratulations and celebrations. When I tell everyone that you're in love with me. Congratulations and jubilations. I want the world to know I'm happy as can be. Who would believe that I could be?
Congratulations, Bill.
Congratulations, Dad.
Congratulations on your retirement.
You have having a great night, and we love you very, very much, and you deserve everything you get.
Loved the speech. It was only 27, what do you call it, and two hee-haws.
Love you, Dad.
Okay. Love you too, Bill.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
I'd always like to say this. Thanks so much for your generosity. Once again, it's overwhelming. We're never taken for granted. So thanks so much for that. All I can say is have a happy retirement. You will be doing stuff that you really enjoy doing. It will be amazing. And yeah, I'm really pleased with you. Fantastic, Bill. Thanks so much.
Thank you for coming at short notice. what you got? First of all, I want to thank what you got, David, Susan, for what you got, the gift, Pam obviously, for the gift they gave you for her diamond, like you can.
More than 50 years would you got all sadness, huh? Any sort, right? So I started with you got the reforming with you got still. But you pay I started at the age of 15 obviously because I was before that would be in the coal mine, but anyway, I started there with you got a hotel with this private firm. And there were six gentlemen, two with dear conferences, and me. And I had my new satchel, brilliant. Brilliant, you get a new satchel.
Oh, what a
gentleman. Well, anyway, I was in there with dear what you got, he and a whole lot. And then he says, usual pranks with these guys, and he's that time, he says, oh, well, you go next door and get a long stand, and by the way, get me a sky hook at the same time. So on. Yeah, all of a sudden I feel for
him. Aye.
Yeah. So, he back up with you, and then he says, right, it's tea time. So, what do you call it? Says, right, what do you call it comes in here as well? So, we made the tea, so I did it in Dark Zealand, I did them in New York, the getting that Ailes Grey and all that stuff, because that's what these guys cook. And after I went to your court, I done that, I said, well, I'll have something to eat myself. Okay, breakfast then, but you can't. Look at my beautiful new bag and all that. Nothing there. I forgot it. Mum was at the flipping door and she said, it's Bill there.
Are you?
Thank you, Mum. Better than what you got. And she said, listen, son, there's your, what you got, six pieces of mince. She said, listen, I know how you like it. And they're all sitting there going. And she says, aye, she says, what you got, she says, Bill's always liked it, you know. So anyway, what you got, Saturday, and they've given me delegates like, what you got, five boys, what you got, chocolate and all that, what have you, pieces. Which I never had delicacies like that when I was young. You can. That's how good your teeth. So anyway, the way it worked out was a matter of, after that, and I got a ribbon, as you can understand, I went into a place called Rosley's Garage. I met the, what you call, the granola greens. Push me apart. Anyway, that's it. No, I was right up your heels. Being a bit of a wicked rock queen's line. And she was looking up my doozer line, that didn't get her. And here, when you've got my gentleman says to me, says, by the way, well, it was this bad. Excuse me, young lady. And she was well developed. And I'm going, can I move me? You've got a youngster, like, you can. 16 and a half.
Shush.
And when you get her, I'm saying, oh, well. She fancied, somebody fancies you, yeah. Ooh, yeah, see. Good, my first love. See what I mean? So anyway, when you got, I went into this office, and I looked for this one, and the attrition's there, when you got the glasses lying there, when you got a cup of tea like that, it's going like that, and I'm going, where? And when you got, she says, hello, and I says, hello, as you would do, like, yeah.
And she says,
so when Kira got up then me smiling and we did go actually with the saucer rather than the cup. So anyway I asked her because that's the sort of guy I am, and she says, well, do you want to go on benefit concert or do you want to go to the pictures? Well, I had 10 shillings in me that time and then my mother and father would be and I had 2 bob. So went to the picture and I kid you, this is true. And it was the Rico him and
you can't remember.
Anyway, I went to meet her, you see, and when she got, I says, I'm no way. 30 seconds later, she came along. She went, we're late. And she came along, she looked at this blue, what you got, she'll tell you anything else that I'm going to tell you, it's different. So she comes along and I says,
you will remember.
Well, I had my hands. I said, you put it in her waist. Very new, when they got the 40 lay for me, it was their name. So as life progressed, and we got married. 10 years later,
oh, right, David.
Anyway, when they got the kids grew up to about 2 and 3 and 5 and 6 and whatever it was. And I used to have a social problem. It's got a Friday night. And that social problem was their problem because the thing there is they said coming, you have a scramble. They love the scramble. Brownie loved it, Sue loved it, he loved it. Scramble, daddies, and social. They're dying to be like flipping limping.
20 quid notes.
But the following day, when I woke up, I realised I'd need money. I went to David and said, could I borrow some money off you? Yeah, lad. I went to Susan.
Your
she said, Susan, can I get some money? She's asking the bank, won't even bother me. So, once again, because obviously I'm borrowing, we got a bit older. It says, David, because he's forthright like again. Used to call me Dad, used to kick me Bumblebee. And when you go, he says, Dad, is it true? He says, you're going to the ranks. I says, could be right, son. And the two of them run along this corridor. Russell! You know, son, she's at the door, I'm going round her neck, saying, when you go, well, please, keep it in touch. So, because they love me so much, I decided, then keep a hobby. So I find that when you got comes in again, like they're there, I'll have to look at my notes. Let me see where we are. Oh I result, aye, go there, aye. I said my arm with your best man. So I'll get to the way of the story stuff off here. Why? You're coming to say that in a minute. Hi. So, as I say, that was my wee bit of coming up with the smashing Harrison kids. Kids, they're the best folk in the world. See you say now when they say it. But anyway, the thing there being is all through that, and all through the video court, could I say, the days were getting bad and different. and one of the best people at the side of me. This young lady here, like, yeah. And the thing with being as a man, I think, family, as in Susan, David, she is, I'm sorry for saying this, Robert, simply the best. I'll wind the night, and I tell you right now, is with this lady here, because I love her so much, and it was John that would you call on Boxing Day. Stevie, would you call, lovely, would you call, would you call, Darlene stating how much she appreciated, loved, and adored what she'd done with her. As I tell you, but I love her lady as well. And the real sense of the word for my family, for myself, this is a person I love so much. And Dave, I think I've got something that we can say. Yay! Well, Woodcock's night was great. I thought that was quite funny. I was in the pictures last night with a wee man and one of my pals, Rod, who's my hairdresser. Lilac. They were sitting in the pictures in Adam and Casey and Jude were sitting in one bit because we're not allowed to sit there. You and Rod's watching the film. And this advert came up and I said, that's Orlando. And I said, well, that's what you got. Anyway, Susan and I were talking about, you know, what could I say about for both of us? And Susan says, well, what's he going to do? Other than annoy my mum, like, every day. She says, well, I says, I suppose there's loads of things you could do. You could. You could maybe take up travel correspondence, he's quite good at that. I mean, when he went down to Blackpool and stopped at Carlisle for a piece and then came back out and then 10 miles later on the motorway they realised they were coming home. And he's really good with directions. He stops this policeman and he said, can you help me some meat for being a what was doing? The guy says, all right. And that self same day, he phoned me. He says, I got lost in my game. He says, oh, where did you go? He says, I was in Kippen. And I says, you can't actually get to Kippen. If you were planning that journey, you couldn't do it. So I thought, well, maybe that's not the thing for him. And I thought, well, he could be a top negotiator. He was really good at that. Mine was the Viva. My dad learnt to drive a year before I learnt to drive. And he bought this Viva, which had a bit of life in it, saying it was more like an Airbnb. So eventually, after a long time, we decided to sell it because Duncan had put parts in it and it didn't work. So we put it in the paper, £250 a year is the offer. So the second guy that said, I'm
on these seats for guns,
he's right, he says, you sell it, so I'm out, you know, and this, turn the boy for a drive. The boy says, how much are you looking for? And I'm standing at the end of the road, looking for a 250. And he's going, it's worth 250. And the guy says, right. So the old boy comes back to do the part, looks out, well, take 200. Well, used to play the drums for the Squires. He used to go there with, look like Engelbert. The old frilly thing on and all that.
Oh, it's awful.
Me and Susan wonder, is the big talking thing? But the most embarrassing thing for us was my pals didn't know he did that. So they used to come round on a Thursday night, and my dad's sitting top of the pops on his full drum set. They used to walk in, all right, okay. So there's a few jobs that you can take up, and I thought, what about sports? You can take up some golf. Golf, he always wanted to try it, he says, take me down the park and teach me to play golf, which is a bit of a joke because I'm hopeless. So I'm trying to get me here this, and here's a neat iron, make it nice and easy. And I was doing it 5 minutes later, he says, oh no, you're doing that wrong. So the long and the short is, I've now heard tonight what he's going to be doing, because he says he's taking up swimming, which is fine, until he says I've bought a pair of Speedos.
Yellow ones like John's.
And all I'm saying is, in my mind, that's not the future. Anyway, I'm not going to bore you for long, other than to say the one thing I can say is my dad, because this isn't a wedding speech, it's no an epitaph either, right? But my dad's came to a point that he's retiring, and the one thing you have to say is, and I know how much he loves my mum. Sorry. But the one thing my dad is, he's an absolute workaholic.
Like to say, it's a pleasure to know you. You're a fantastic man. I value you as one of my closest friends, and I just hope you have a fantastic retirement, mate. All the best. What do you want to say?
Bill, just have a wonderful retirement. You're an absolutely wonderful person. I'm so proud to know you, and I know Susan is one of my closest friends. Is absolutely as proud as punch of you as a dad. So we just want to wish you all the very, very best. We look forward to having lots of really good times with you, all our families together.
And last word is, come on a Steny. And I look forward to seeing you once we get promoted for the third division. Come on.
Hi Bill, you have a long and happy retirement, and thank you for everything you have done for Dublin.
And can I just say one thing? Your non-division should be no problem, because that was anything at all you wanted, Duncan, no problem. Cheers, Bill.
Thank you, Bill. Bye.
Hi Bill, happy birthday and happy retirement, and thanks a lot for being the greatest champion of the world, and we love you.
All the best Bill, cheers.
Take it easy, take it easy. Don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy.
Really, don't be a hero, don't be a fool with your life. Really.
Bill's grandson. I want to say that Bill is an absolute downright hard worker, and he's a painter who usually does about a building on his own. And he's a great grandfather, and he will do anything for you. And he deserves a retirement because he put about 200% into anything he has worked on. But I just want to thank you, Grandad, for being a massive benefit to my life. And he has been a great father too, and taught my dad and auntie how to be nice people. Thank you.